paneer tikka. Whether you are enjoying this with your friends at the streets or at the restaurants with your family and relatives, does not matter. What matters is you will always get the same taste of the tikka and you always like it. But the best part is you can easily make this at home and with your own flavors, and you will get better and better every time.
Hello and welcome to Chef Lal's Kitchen. Today we are gonna be making a paneer tikka recipe called Badami Paneer Tikka. So let's get started.
So the ingredients we need for this recipe are half a tablespoon of red chili powder, half a tablespoon of coriander powder, half a tablespoon of turmeric powder, half a tablespoon of black pepper powder, 1 tablespoon of ginger and garlic paste, 1 tablespoon of lemon juice, some salt to taste, around a quarter tablespoon of chaat masala powder. Then take around 16 to 18 of almonds along with 2 tablespoons of water and make a paste out of it. Then we need half a cup of yogurt. Now instead of slicing, cut the veggies into squares. So we need 1 capsicum, 1 onion, and around 1 or 2 tomatoes. Now I am gonna take around 250 grams of paneer and cut it into a little bigger cubes than we need in the curry. Now we need to marinate the paneer, so I am gonna take a large bowl. To this, add the yogurt. The ginger and garlic paste, the red chili powder, the coriander powder, then the turmeric powder, the black pepper powder. Now goes the almond paste, and this is the reason we call it the Badami Paneer Tikka. Then some salt to taste and the lemon juice. Now give it a mix. Now if you want to add some chopped green chili, you can add that. But don't add any garam masala or any other spices, or else you will not get any flavor of the almond, because that will be a strong flavor and will cancel the flavor of the almond. But you can add coriander leaves or any other. Now gently coat the paneer. Then add the onion, the capsicum, and the tomato. Gently mix everything and let it marinate for 2 hours in the refrigerator. Now I have some steel skewers here, but you can use wooden also, but soak them in the water for at least 20 minutes before using them. Now I am gonna put the capsicum first, then the onion, then the tomato, then 2 paneer cubes. Then again we'll repeat the same procedure. You don't have to follow the same pattern. You can add even only onion or red bell peppers, yellow bell peppers or anything. The first one is ready. Now similarly we will make the other sticks. Now I have 5 sticks, so I am gonna cook 3 of them in the oven and 2 of them in the pan. For this we have to preheat the oven at 200 degrees Celsius for 10 minutes. In my case it's an OTG. Now take the tray and cover it with the aluminium foil. Add 2 tablespoons of oil so that the paneer cubes won't stick to it. Then place the paneer tikka on the tray. Then place the tray in the oven and cook for 7 to 8 minutes at 200 degrees Celsius. After 8 minutes, turn them upside down and again cook for 7 to 8 minutes. Now to make it in the pan, heat 1 tablespoon of oil. Reduce the flame to medium, then place the paneer tikka. Then after 2 minutes, turn the upside down and cook for another 2 to 3 minutes. Now you can see the outside of the paneer is completely cooked and the center will be soft and juicy. Now switch off the flame and time for plating. Garnish it with some sliced onion, half a lemon and sprinkle some chaat masala on the top. And that's it, badami paneer tikka is ready. And do try this at home. And remember, don't just eat to live, live to eat. Thanks for watching. For more info, visit my website and don't forget to subscribe.